Did he? Nice job.
Study. Get good grades. Do your homework. What good does that do? What if you do study and it doesn't help? This is perfect. Icing on the cake of a rough week. I can't wait for the weekend to start.
I'm texting my boyfriend some more.
Good, Crystal?
Not much, I'm ready to fight.
Let's do it.
Are we going tomorrow?
Yeah.
I'm excited.
How are you? Not too good.
How rough week?
Yeah.
Sorry, I hope you have a good night though.
Thanks. Hey, Crystal. Hi. So down the party off of that. Here, come on.
Whoa, what are those?
Oh, I got these from my friend. Want to try some?
I don't know. Trust me, it's tons of fun. Okay, well, I guess whatever works.
Try some.
What is that?
Just some Smirnoff.
Whoa.
Wait. Okay, hold on. Oh my god.
Hey!
Oh my god. Oh,
hey guys! Guys, like, there's actually something wrong.
What?
Just let her sleep it off.
She's fine.
No, guys, I think we should call 911. No, she's fine.
She's
what? Fine. How could she be fine? Look at her.
She's probably just tired.
She's not okay.
Just let her sleep.
Zach Greenwald, class of 2005. I'm here to talk about suicide awareness and tell my story about what it's like to think that there's no way out, and that to talk about how it feels to think there's only a permanent solution for a temporary problem. Just kind of fell down the dark hole and isolated myself, put on a happy face at school. At first, I wasn't getting help. I was angry. I was lashing out at my parents and my brother and my friends, and I was putting all this negative energy where it didn't belong, to kind of use as a defense for how really unhappy I was. Eventually I started to go to therapy, and I started to talk to people about what was going on. I was lucky to have faculty members at the school on my side. I was an athlete, was a basketball player, so Mrs. Pettit was of great help to me. She really bailed me out in a few really tough situations that I can remember really specifically. It stayed pretty rough throughout senior year. It was a really difficult time. I was suicidal, and my thoughts were really dark, and I decided to get some help for myself. So, this is April 7th, 2005. I was at home after school, and I thought I wanted to kill myself. You know, I thought that was it. And there was this flash of light that told me, don't do it. So I brought myself to the library here where my mom was working at the time, and I told her I needed help. I told her I needed serious help. So we talked to Dr. Pell, talked to Mrs. Pettit, we called my therapist, and we all decided that I should check into Vista Del Mar Hospital in Ojai so that I wouldn't hurt myself, and was put on a hold. And I knew I needed to be there as much as I felt I didn't want to be. And in the end, I'm so grateful for that experience. I'm grateful that instead of making one small but permanent huge move, I got help. I think that my friends saw what was going on with me, but they didn't know how to bring it up. They knew I had some anger problems, and I know they were probably a little scared to ask me if I needed help or to really deeply inquire about the situation. If my friends would have intervened about the situation, I think I would have been receptive. If you know that things aren't okay with somebody that you love, or somebody around you at all, you know, life's too short and too precious to not say anything about it. There's really no reason not to. If someone is going to act mad about it, they're going to thank you later when it comes down to it. The local teen deaths and suicides that have been going on around here, it really breaks my heart to think about the pain first that these kids were feeling, and now that everybody in their lives are feeling. It just doesn't have to be that way. And there's so few things in life that are irreversible. All my problems that I look back on now, even at this young age, all my problems that I look back on now seem so minuscule. They've all come and gone and there have been solutions. And they can be reversed. So many mistakes in life can be reversed, no matter how terrible they feel right now. But something like that, ending your life, that's it. As far as we know, you've only got one. And it's, you know, our lives are the most precious thing we have. I've lost friends since high school's ended in the past 6 years. I've had friends die. I've had friends make stupid choices. And it hurts. And until you feel that pain, you can't imagine what people would feel like to not have you in their lives anymore. That pain is indescribable. It's deep and it sucks, and it never really goes away. I had a friend once who went through some depression of her own, pretty serious for a while, and she said she was walking along campus one day at UCSB, and for months and months she had just seen these big lawns out there, and everything was kind of a blur and everything was kind of dull. And one day she told me that she looked at these fields and she actually saw the blades of grass. And she said that was her blades of grass moment. And I know that I've had mine. And I know that everybody can have that moment where the colors come back and, you know, the music sounds beautiful again, and the love can really hit your heart from everything around in life. There's just so much going on. There's so much to be discovered and so much to feel, good and bad. So how could I stress enough to just stick it out and to just keep living?